Hello and welcome everyone to the Daily Dose where we discuss top 5 current affairs. Sorry, my video got started a bit later. Where we discuss top 5 current affairs with a bonus topic, and the bonus topic continues to be women who fought, starting with a small quote with a big meaning. Happiness is all about enjoying little things in life, and you know, smaller things should give you the happiness, and you need to find happiness in small things, and that will make your life happier. And let us start with such a spirit. Let us start. Let us attack top 5 current affairs. Rajasthan unfortunately declares mucormycosis or black fungus as an epidemic. There's a difference between epidemic and pandemic. Now, party decision. Kerala CM Pinarayi Vijayan decides to drop KK Shailaja from his cabinet. Now, who is this KK Shailaja? She is the woman who helped Kerala combat coronavirus. And initially, we used to find in the news that Kerala is in a better position than any other states. So it was because KK Shailaja, she had taken really appreciable administrative measures, and that's why Kerala was in a good position, but now it is deteriorating. And Pinarayi Vijayan decides to drop her from the cabinet. Let us see the repercussions. Then concern over black fungus drug shortage in India. There's a global concern about the black fungus. What is it? And how are we going to combat it? Then Netanyahu determined to continue bombarding in the Gaza until Israel's aim is fulfilled or aim is met. Now, what is Israel's aim? I have made a detailed report on Israel-Palestine. You are requested to visit my channel and see that video, please. So Netanyahu, he is determined. So what, I'll brief you something more about Israel-Gaza, Israel-Palestine attack in this video. Shortly, we'll complete it. So what has happened? This war, how has it started? It was started about because there were differences in the opinions about East Jerusalem. Israel bola ki yaar mujhe East West Jerusalem kuch nahi samajhta. I want whole Jerusalem as my capital. Then Palestine said that yaar ye to galat baat hai. It was pre-decided ki East Jerusalem future Palestinian state ka capital hoga. So that's why East Jerusalem ko leke unke jhagde hain. Then moving on to a very interesting news. Elon Musk loses world's second richest tag. And then who takes it? Of course, this is a question which everyone should ask. LVMH is a luxury company, leading luxury brand LVMH. And this company's owner, Bernard Arnault, he takes up the second richest tag. So Elon Musk unfortunately loses world's second richest tag. And this is the symbol of Tesla. Many of you may not know this. That's why I have put up here. And let us move on to women who fought. Now, those who don't know Nadia Murad, please don't quit the video. Please don't leave it half. Watch it till the end. See, it is very interesting to know new things. So women who fought Nadia Murad, and I promise you, I assure you that you will be left thunderstruck, and you will feel a mix of horror and inspiration. So kindly stay tuned till the end. Starting with Nadia Murad. Now, who was Nadia Murad? She was the first Nobel Peace Prize winner from Iraq. Nobel Peace Prize winner from Iraq. First Nobel Peace Prize winner from Iraq. She's an Iraqi Yazidi. I will tell you what is this Yazidi. She's an Iraqi Yazidi human rights activist who lives in Germany currently. And when she was 21, IS militants, Islamic State militants, attacked her village in northern Iraq, close to the border with Syria. And the militants killed those who refused to get converted to Islam, including 6 of her 9 brothers and her mother. She was captured and endured at the hands of the militants for 3 months, complete 3 months. Can you imagine? So who is this Nadia Murad? So Nadia Murad basically hails from Iraq, and she currently lives in Germany, and she was like captured, she was tortured by IS militants, that is Islamic State militants, they were also, Islamic State militants for complete 3 months. And she was not the only girl. They took many girls. They took many girls, captured them, tortured them to their death. Let us see what happens next. What was the situation like and what are her contributions? Who is this gentleman? Let us talk about it. In an interview, she said that escaping the militants was like an impossible task. If by chance you get caught, the repercussions are worst. She also said that the Daesh militants, the IS militants, like the Islamic State militants, were given a name of Daesh militants in Mosul. Mosul is a place. They were spread, and there was no chance of girls escaping. She once tried to escape but was caught and put in a cell and tortured by all the men in the compound. It is so ghastly. A Muslim family finally helped her escape the horrendous situation. They provided her with an Islamic ID and took her to the border. Many women killed themselves. My God, many women killed themselves. They thought that being in the hands of the Daesh militants was like dying every minute. So why not die at once? So this was so, we cannot imagine women in a trepidation to women in a continuous trepidation ki ab aayenge wo militants, ab aayenge, they'll torture us. So this is really unimaginable. And what are her contributions? She runs the Nadia's initiative, which is dedicated to rebuild communities in times of crisis and advocate globally for survivors of sexual violence. And this gentleman is Dr. Dennis Mukwege. Now, he's a gynec. Dennis Mukwege and Nadia Murad, they together got Nobel Prize for Peace in 2018 recently. And along with Nadia, he was also awarded with the Nobel Prize for Peace. He helped thousands of rape victims. Now, I would like to brief you more about Dennis Mukwege. He's a gynecologist, as I told you, from Democratic Republic of Congo. And he was shocked to see first victim because she was shot. She was shot. Bullets were also fired at her. And she was sexually harassed, and some 45 women came with the same story to the gynecologist, and he was like shocked to see the condition of the women, and some had bullets fired at them while some had acid burns. So can you imagine the torture which they had to bear with? So this is very, very unimaginable. And Nadia Murad says that, I want to be the last girl in the world with a story like mine. So it is so heartbreaking. Thanks for watching though. And I wish you a very good health and stay healthy. Stay masked.